Hey guys! Welcome back to architutors. In this Rhino tutorial, we will look into how to model a parametric design like 3D model in Rhino 8. So let's begin. First, in Rhino, we need to set up a reference geometry that works as a guide. So let's start by drawing a polyline in the shape of a side elevation for our geometry. We're going to model a geometry for a parametric bench, so create the polyline accordingly. Tell us where you're watching this video from, and if you're a regular Rhino user, what Rhino tutorials would you like to see next? In any case, make sure you subscribe to our channel as we come up with regular uploads on Rhino and Grasshopper. Next, use the curve command to create curve around the guideline we created. Construct the curve using number of points that we can move to alter the shape of the curve. We can delete the polyline. Use points to make the curve into a desired shape. We need multiple copy of this curve that we can loft to create a 3D geometry in Rhino. Use array linear command to create multiple copies. Define number of copies. Let's say 6 and define direction for it. Hit enter to apply. To create surface of these curves, select all curves and fill command loft. Also turn the record history option on, that will basically automatically change the geometry as we change the shape of the curves in Rhino. Hit OK to continue. Now if we move the curve, you see the lofted geometry also changes and follows the curve. This is how we can create some interesting design for our model in Rhino. We can move the curves or we can move the points on the curve to create some interesting designs. Simply select the curve and select the points on the curve that you can move in different directions to change the shape of the curve that will ultimately change the geometry of the loft surface that we created. Let us fast forward, but you can take time to alter these curves as these will define the design we're creating. Now to close the surfaces we can use cap command. Use contour command to divide the volume into a number of curves that we'll make into panels. Define direction and dimension. Let's group these curves and to extrude them into fins or panels, use command extrude curve. Turn solid option on and define offset. This is how you can create interesting parametric design or parametric geometry in Rhino. Check out more of such tutorials on Rhino and Grasshopper on our channel. And make sure you subscribe to our channel and hit the notification bell icon for all the latest updates. Thanks for watching. See you next time.